Entombed Valley, and I can already spoil you guys before we are actually in game that Quantic Spanishua is our yellow Zerg spawning on the right top side. You really find that that's funny, but
no, I'm actually embarrassed that I did that.
No, I think it was not myself. Bad. I think if you would have, like, I think the punchline could have been better.
Well, the thought process with the paintings were rolling, but I kind of realized that
you should never. Wow, now you're making a big mistake. You should never explain the joke.
Yeah, you're right.
Because then you dumb
gotta,
it down.
You gotta just own it, man. Yeah. Good call, Kev.
Rolling, rolling, rolling. Keep those paintings rolling.
See, your Hue and Light is so nice. It's like the nicest chat I've ever seen in my life. He said that his internet cafe is apparently not KT, which I think is an internet provider. So the connection from his current internet cafe is not very good to the North American server. And he also said that Quantic Spanishua is very, very good. So he will most likely not beat him. Now, this would be extremely bad mannered if CEO Jung Light suddenly crushes Spanishua 2-0.
He's getting mannered.
Yeah. he is getting mannered. For the people who don't know the story behind this, in the very early days of the beta, Mana played in a tournament against Hazuops, and then all that Mana was typing was in the Go for Soccer 2 semi-final. He's like, go easy on me. You're so good, Hazu. And Hazu was like, okay, good luck, have fun. And then Mana's like, no, really, I can't beat you. You're so good. You're like the big favorite. And Hazu is just like, mm-hmm. And then like Mana just keeps going, okay, go easy, okay, good luck, have fun. And in the end, Mana wins 2-0. And he's like, Hazu is kind of pissed off. And in the next round, the Muslim played against Mana. And then the Muslim asked the Mana, you played against Hazu, right, in the last round? And Mana's like, yeah. And the Muslim's like, how did it go? Mana's like, easy. So Hazu gets really mad. And since then, they've always, in Europe, on the European scene, they've called it Manaing each other. And the Muslim and Naniwa did it once very much for a long time. They said, go easy on me. Nah, you go easy on me. You're so much better. And then the other, I think Naniwa once said, like, I'm like a kitty without legs when I have to play against you. They just went ridiculous.
Oh, that reminds me of my kitty.
And one time the Muslim played against Tarzan, and then the Muslim tried to mana him. And Tarzan was not even part of this entire conversation. And Muslim just wrote, good luck, have fun, Tarzan. Go easy on me. You're so good. And then Tarzan replied, don't try to mana me. And the Muslim was like, what the hell, you know? Tarzan was like, yes, of course. He's famous for it. But since then, Mana had a little bit too much success to still be manaing people. So unfortunately, manaing people have died out.
Mana's such a great guy. Is he in Korea yet?
Yes, he is, with his brother and Draco.
Draco. From Brood War?
I like to say Drago.
Draco's Russian, if I'm not mistaken?
No, he's Polish.
He's Polish too?
Yeah, man.
I didn't know that. That's so cool, man.
Yeah, Draco is like the coolest guy ever.
The Poles taking over.
Well, we see two Rexes going up in the main base of CU Young Light, and of course his Natural is going up as well. While Spanisha is just droning up, I can share a small story of Draco. Once upon a time, World Cyber Games 2009 ban, we went out in China to a club, and Draco had a few drinks, and he had the button shirt, and suddenly he went nuts. And he ripped off his shirt open in the club, and he's like, I'm Draco! And he's just like running around this Chinese club, telling strangers, hey, don't you know who I am? I'm Draco! I was like, hey man, relax. He's like, no, I'm Draco. They have to. And the next day I met him, I was like, hey, Draco! He's like, oh yeah, that happened. It was awesome.
To be completely fair, he was really, really good at Brood War, one of the best ever.
People should know, man. If you're that good, people should know.
He was a beast. He never really did much in StarCraft 2, though, sadly. Nope,
played a little bit in the start of the beta. I remember actually playing against him once, and he smiled because he immediately remembered my nickname, and he remembered the times that we had in China.
Did you type, I'm Draco?
And also in a different context. It was not just, I'm Draco. It was a little bit different. And yeah, he smiled. He laughed. Would be fun to see him play a lot in Korea, but I don't think that's going to be the case. Anyways, Ben, we see both extractors in the natural going down for Spanishua. Well, Spanishua once more, of course, in traditional Spanishua style, goes up to three bases very, very quickly.
Yep. And notably, Kev,
man, his injects are so good.
Yeah, they're great, man. He's also stopping on four queens. So while the current meta is maybe go up to six queens, a lot of players are doing that these days. Spanishua still just does it this way. So you can really see that he does not pull from what other people do. He really plays his own way.
Well, Ben, I think CU Young Light is going to go for some crazy all-in. And that's, of course, not the hardest observation. If you see five Rexes and no gas yet, 7 minutes into this game, he's going to send out a small hit squad at front and then try to hide a bigger one. I think that's pretty smart, but this Overlord is brilliant positioning.
A beautiful spot to place this Overlord. Will he see? Oh.
No, he will see it
yeah,
with this
second
one.
Overlord will spot it. Now Spinny Shuan
knows. But he just made 5 more drones, man.
He will start up extra spine crawler. Speed is not. Wow, that is a huge.
This is a pretty scary push.
This is going to be really hard.
29 army supply. Against 15.
He is pulling these queens, but they're going to take a long. They got to go off. This is
going to be so hard for Spinny Shuan.
Now, that said, if he fights with drones, he can still come out okay here, and he is pulling drones off the lines. SCVs in the front are going to absorb a great deal of damage. 2 more queens coming from behind. Oh, this is a great choice. Clicking on minerals to pull the drones through, and he will get up on top of these marines and Spanishiwa. It's not over yet, but I think he is going to hold, Kev. Energy for transfusion, no.
A lot of links streaming him, but they're still slow links, so they die pretty easily as well. But more and more links are on the way, and this one Spinecrawler. It's probably the hero right now. That's
the
savior.
Behind it with energy for transfusion, or the queen behind it with energy for transfusion, I should say.
It's a guardian.
Yep, that's basically saying.
Right now, Spanishua is still 15 workers ahead, despite losing quite a few drones. He's still 16 workers ahead, and he's macroing links out of 3 bases. Yep. Did he pull all drones from the main? Yes, he did. Wow, that's crazy.
That's what you have to do. Yeah. He overreacted, and he handled it, and that is so brilliant. Speed is about to finish, and when it does, it's going to be 21 lings against this. Well, it's still a really formidable number of Marines.
Yeah, but most of them are not there, actually. A lot of them are almost there or are still on the way. Here come all those Zerglings. Spanisha's
really
going for
nice
the counter.
Choice. Really nice choice. He can, he could be killing these reinforcing units. And that's exactly what's going to happen. Start picking these guys off piece by piece. Transfusion needs to go down, and it does go down. It's a great transfuse. Drones are again being pulled. Lings do come back and catch these units from behind. Does he get the full surround? Not quite, but he is going to kill a lot of these Marines. Maybe all of these Marines, yes. Spanishua will clean up this force. The
great,
rest of the SCV is showing up. And Seohun Light showing...
I mean, it's still not over as there are still a couple of Marines, but right now he's not mining anything. And he just calls GG Spanishua advances to the semifinals.
Top 4. His next opponent will be Arthur from Team Slayers, our other two players in the semifinal.
No, he's actually going to play against Dark, I think. I think it's SCC versus Archer and Dark versus Spanishua.
That means Coco was eliminated.
Ooh.
Then so Dark. I think Coco must have lost to Dark?
Yes, I think that's correct. Maybe we can get a confirmation of that of one of our production crews. That's crazy.
That is incredible. STC, Arthur, Dark, all Koreans, and well, then Spanishua, the North American hope. Wow, it's been a long time since we've been able to say that, but there is a North American repping it in the top 4. Spanishua will play against Arthur tomorrow. Okay. STC versus Dark, and then the winners of each will square off to see who earns
that. So we could have an all-Quantic final as well. Man, they would be happy with that.
That would be really cool. That would be great for Quantic, in fact.
It sure would be. Anyway, guys, we're going to head over to a final small commercial break, but don't go anywhere yet. We're going to bring you guys more updates regarding this qualifier, and then we're going to close out the show. So stay tuned. 1 minute break, and we'll be right back, and then we'll close it out.